Hi everyone and welcome to another Cloudwards video. My name is Mauricio and today we'll be talking about cloud storage security. We'll go over how safe cloud storage is to use, what makes a cloud service secure, and we'll also throw in a few recommendations if you want to try out a secure cloud storage service. This video is part of our Cloud Storage 101 series, so make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you get notified when the next video drops. If you're not quite familiar with how cloud storage works yet, check out our quick explainer video on cloud storage right here. So with that out of the way, let's just jump right in, shall we? So how safe is cloud storage? Well, the short answer is it's very safe as long as you're using a secure service. I personally use cloud storage every day. I mean, our channel is called Cloudwards after all, and I've never had one of my accounts hacked or even lost a file. But that's not the case for everyone. You can easily use your files if you put your trust in the wrong cloud service, or if you just have poor security habits like setting password 123 as your password. So let's take a look at what it takes for a cloud service to be secure and how to best protect your data. First, let's talk a bit about cloud features. Simply put, there are a few security features a service needs to have to be safe enough to trust. There can be any number of cloud security features, and some services offer novel security solutions of their own. But we'll be looking at the two most important features, and that's two-factor authentication and zero-knowledge encryption. Two-factor authentication, or 2FA, is one of the most important security features to look for. And if you use similar passwords across different websites, it can be a lifesaver. Basically, whenever someone tries to log into your account, you get a notification, either via email or 2FA app on your phone. You then need to approve the login yourself, and if it wasn't you trying to get in, you can just deny the login attempt. Icedrive, one of our favorite cloud storage services, used to lack this feature, but now, fortunately, it has it. Now, let's talk about encryption. Encryption is what stops people from looking at your files. It scrambles them into a form that's unreadable without the encryption key. Obviously, a service needs to encrypt your files, both while they're on its servers and while they're traveling from your device to those servers. But who holds that encryption key can make a huge difference for safety and privacy of your files. Zero knowledge encryption is what you really want in a service. If a cloud company holds the encryption key to your files, then it can decrypt them and view them or scan them and even turn them over to the government. However, with zero-knowledge encryption in place, you are the only one with access to your encryption key. This means that not even the cloud service itself can decrypt your files. And this is much simpler than it looks. All of this encryption and decryption happens automatically. So it's not like you have to manually enter your key every time you want to access a file. So it's always a net positive, and it doesn't add any complications to how you use your own cloud storage. For example, sync.com and Mega offer zero-knowledge encryption for every file you upload, so everything on there is always perfectly secure. Now let's talk about privacy features. Stuff like privacy policies and terms of service can be complicated and frankly too complex to cover in detail in a short video. Now, you don't necessarily need to go through a company's 10,000-word policy, so we'll give you a few pointers about what you need to keep an eye out for. But before we get into the privacy policies, make no mistake, every online service collects some of your data. That's just how the internet works. For example, if a cloud service says that it collects your email and payment info, that's pretty much what's going to happen. After all, it needs to send you emails and charge you for the service. But a good service might also use cookies to track how you use its website and where you access it from. If you're not comfortable with that, you can always disable cookies in your browser and it won't be able to track anything. You also need to check how a service shares your data. Most services will share user data with trusted partners, which usually refers to stuff like outsourced customer support reps or a server provider. But if you see that it shares your data with advertisers like Google Drive or OneDrive do, that's a big red flag that you need to steer clear of that service. Another important factor is privacy laws. Simply put, you should avoid companies in countries with intrusive surveillance laws like the United States, where Dropbox is located, for example. You should especially steer clear of companies in places like China or Russia, where The government has a lot of control over the internet. Companies in privacy havens like Switzerland, the EU, or the British Virgin Islands are the best places to store your sensitive data. For example, Pcloud is based in Switzerland and its servers are in EU countries, which means your data is protected by some of the best privacy laws in the world. One important thing to note is that a zero-knowledge service can't unlock your files, so a country's privacy laws can force it to surrender your files even if it wanted to. For example, sync.com might be based in Canada, which is part of the Five Eyes spy network, but it's so secure that there's virtually no chance that anyone but you can ever access your files. So, with all the cloud security and privacy features out of the way, here are a few cloud security best practices. First, use a strong, unique password. Never use your cloud storage password for any other online service. Next, always keep two-factor authentication activated, no matter how annoying you think it is to push a button on your phone whenever you log in from a different device. Disable cookies in your browser. Use zero-knowledge encryption. That means that if a service only offers zero-knowledge for one folder in your account, always use that folder to sync your files to. And finally, make sure to choose the right service, one that has all the features we talked about in this video. And as a final treat, here are a few of our top recommendations for secure cloud storage. First up is sync.com. It's our favorite overall cloud storage service, but it's also the most secure. Not only does it come with all the features we mentioned, but it covers all of your storage with zero-knowledge encryption. Plus, it's even certified to keep sensitive medical files under HIPAA. See our full sync.com review video right here if you are interested, or read the written version also linked down below. Another very secure service is Pcloud. This is one service that really takes your privacy seriously, and you can trust it to keep your files safe. It's based in Switzerland with servers in the EU, so you don't have to worry about the US government snooping in on you either. We have a review of Pcloud as well. Just click right here if you want to see more about it, and also a detailed in-depth 45-minute walkthrough through that software also here in the description. Our last recommendation, but certainly not least, is Icedrive. It's a fairly new service, but it's already become one of the best cloud storage services, period. It prides itself on keeping your data private and offers zero knowledge out of the box, as well as two-factor authentication. Of course, we also have a review of Icedrive right here, so go watch that one if you think that could be right for you. Guys, that is it for this video. We've covered a lot of topics. We hope you enjoyed it, and please give it a thumbs up if you did. It really helps the channel and lets us keep making those amazing videos for you guys. Of course, subscribe and hit the bell icon if you haven't already. We have a ton of useful cloud storage content on our channel, so take a look if you're interested. We also do written articles on our website, cloudwards.net, and there are links to more in-depth articles on the topics we talked about in the description below. Please let us know your thoughts on cloud security in the comments. We'd love to hear them. And as always, thank you very much for watching, and see you in our next video. Bye-bye.